Okay, now that we know what people have thought about personality in the past, it'll be clear as to why we are where we are now. The trait models of personality seem to be the dominant theoretical models now, particularly in research and a lot of settings like recruitment for jobs and assessment in a clinical setting. We started talking about personality types, which are different from traits. For example, people say things like, I don't like rock concerts because I'm an introvert, or I love skydiving because I'm an extrovert. I'd like to just highlight the difference. One of the very first theories of personality was actually a type model of personality. It's called Humoral Theory. The idea was that you could characterize a person's personality based on what sort of humor or fluid they had in excess in their body. For example, for choleric type of people, these people had too much yellow bile. They would be bad-tempered and irritable. For melancholic people, they had too much black bile. They'd be gloomy and pessimistic. Phlegmatic people, for them, it was too much phlegm, which would mean they would be sluggish, calm, and unexcitable. And for those who were sanguine, they had too much blood, making them cheerful and passionate. It's probably no surprise that when you actually measure people's fluids in their body, the ratio of fluids is unrelated to their personality. There's no biological evidence for humoral theory. Despite that, people still continued to think about personality in terms of types for a long time. Even Freud was a typist. As we've seen though, personality is partly inherited. The evidence for inheritance of genes makes it quite difficult to believe there's distinct types of personality. You have all different types of personality, but through mixed breeding and inheritance, everybody should end up with a mix of all the types. That's not the case necessarily. So now, what we think of as personality is not so much about types, like introverts and extroverts. What we're actually talking about is where we would score on the dimension of extroversion. Extroverts would score high, and introverts would score low. It's not so much that someone is an extrovert, but that they score high on the measure of extroversion. The analogy is sometimes when we're talking about people's height, we might say they're short or they're tall. But really, what we're referring to is the underlying dimension of height. And it's just that we simplify that dimension by using categories. But really, height is the continuous variable that people can be compared on. That's what we mean when we're talking about traits versus types.